Hey guys, welcome to the channel. This video is on transistor biasing and we are going to talk on the fixed bias circuit with respect to its analysis and its design. Let's begin. For a fixed bias configuration, we'll need a transistor. It has three terminals, emitter, base and collector. The transistor we used here is of the NPN type. To build a fixed bias circuit, we will need two resistors, one which connects to the collector terminal and the other which connects to the base terminal. The circuit will be powered with a DC supply. If you observe, the top nodes get a plus VCC onto them and the node which is at the emitter terminal gets a minus VCC, or we call it a ground. So if you redraw the circuit, you will get a transistor with two resistors RC and RB connected to it, powered with a DC supply VCC and the emitter terminal connected to the ground. We will use this configuration for the rest of the video. Talking of analysis, we will have to identify three parameters: one base current, one collector current, and the third is going to be the voltage across collector emitter terminals. As this is a closed circuit, there will be a flow of current in it. The current which flows through the base resistor is called IB, that's the base current. The current that flows through the collector resistance is called IC, and the voltage that appears across the collector emitter terminals is called VCE. By analysis, we mean finding out the value for these three parameters. Now, to start with the analysis, we will have to divide the circuit into two parts. One is the input circuit, the other is the output circuit. The input circuit is also called as the base emitter circuit. It can be constructed by shifting the VCC to the base side and eliminating the collector resistance and the connecting cables. The output circuit, which is called as the collector emitter circuit, can be built by shifting the VCC on the collector side, eliminating the base resistance and the connecting cables. Consider the input circuit. If you write a KVL equation for this circuit, you will have to first consider VCC, the current that flows in the base resistor RB is going to be IB, that will create a voltage drop of IBRB, and the voltage drop which appears across base emitter is given as VBE. Equate the equation to zero. Rearranging the terms, you will get the value for base current as VCC minus VBE upon RB. And that is the expression for the first unknown parameter, that is IB. When you solve numericals, you will realize that VBE is a very small number in comparison to VCC. Hence, IB can be approximated as VCC upon RB. Considering the output circuit, when you write a KVL for that, you will get a plus VCC, minus ICRC because of the current that goes in the collector resistance, and a term minus VCE because of the voltage drop across collector emitter, and equate the expression to zero. Rearranging the terms to get value for VCE, you'll get it as VCC minus ICRC. That is an expression for the second unknown quantity, that is VCE. And the third unknown quantity, that is IC, can be found out as beta times IB because of the configuration. Now with that, we have completed the three equations for the three unknown parameters. Moving over to the second part, that is design, we mean calculating the value for RB, RC, voltage drop VB, VC and VE. So in the design phase, we will have to find out an expression or value for all these parameters. I list them down on the top row. and we begin with the last term, that is VE. You can see that VE is connected to the ground, so the value for that is going to be 0, and that is our first value for the unknown. The second parameter, that is VB, is written as VBE equals VB minus VE. The value for VBE is 0.7 volts if it's a silicon transistor, and it is 0.3 volts if it's a germanium transistor. The one which we are considering here is silicon, so we write the value as 0.7. And from expression 1, you know that VE already equals 0, hence VB is written as 0.7 volts. And that is the second unknown parameter which we just found a value for. The third is the collector voltage VC, which can be written as VCE equals VC minus VE. Again, VE equals 0, hence VC equals VCE. That's the three unknown voltages. Now moving over to the resistances, the expression for RB can be found out if you write a KVL equation for the input loop, which can be written as VCC minus VBE upon RB. And from the previous slide, you know that VBE is a difference of VB and VE. So the VBE term can be substituted as just VB. And hence, recomputing, you get the expression for RB as shown here. And the last term, that is RC, can be calculated in the similar fashion. Consider the output loop and write a KVL for it. Substitute VCE by VC and rearrange the terms to get VCC minus VC upon IC. To end the video, I list some of the advantages and disadvantages of the fixed bias circuit. Stay tuned for my more BJT configurations. Until then, like, share, and subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.